In this episode of the UMC 500 series, we're making chips and we're going to show you our unique approach to using three of our products to make one of our components. Let's get started. So in this episode of the UMC 500 series, we are making this product. This is our hand valve. It's just a simple air valve. The story behind this is we wanted to bring all of our manufacturing, not just in-house, but back from overseas. The original hand valves we were buying came from all over the world, and we had quality issues over time. And there just wasn't a great domestic source for an inexpensive hand valve, so we started producing them ourselves. Now, the thing about this is there's lots of machining on all sides. Obviously, there is the top profile, there is a left, a right, a bottom side, as well as our sticker pocket that we pocket out so we can place it so it's perfectly centered. So five out of the six sides on this workpiece get machined. This is perfect for five-axis machining, but it's also expensive. So the plus side to five-axis machining is you get to hit all sides. The downside is you're typically only working on one part at a time. But let me give you a closer look and I'll show you how we get the best of both worlds using three of our products. Let's get in closer. Welcome to the inside of the machine. Okay, so from the top down, this is our RotoVise product. And this is a slightly shorter in-house version that we made just for the fun of it. We had a little extra material, but it works perfectly in this. Our normal off-the-shelf RotoVise would also work. The only thing that's different is the body extends and gives a little bit more travel. It's perfect for 3-inch cube work pieces. So what we've done here is we're holding four of our hand valves per station. And as you can see, we can access the bottom, the left side porting, the right side porting, and the pocket where the sticker goes. After these four come off, they go to an adjacent machine where we only machine off the top, which would be this surface here, and bring it to size, and the part is finished. Now, we've taken the RotoVise and we've mounted it to our second product, which is our Pro Pallet. This is an 8x12 size, and we've made a really cool design in Fusion 360. We've taken the outer profile, the rectangular 8x12, and we have lofted it to a circle to match the diameter of the mounting flange of the RotoVise. And it gives this really cool transition from rectangle to circle, which if you ask me, I think it looks pretty sick. And finally, our pallet's locked down to our Pro Pallet base. Now our Pro Pallet and our Mini Pallet systems use springs to keep everything locked, but they used compressed air, not vacuum, compressed air to compress the springs and unlock the system, which draws in the six ball locks per locking mechanism. So these Pro Pallet systems work great in a three-axis vertical because you can run an airline to one of the air valves that sits on the table. But in a five-axis environment, it's a little bit different because you have the B and the C axis that are turning and twisting, and really there's not a lot of real estate to put one of these hand valves on. Now, the way that we get around that is to use a quick disconnect. Let me grab that. Okay, this is known as a Japanese style quick disconnect fitting. So the nice thing about this is it's one-handed operation. Simply push it on and it locks. And when you're done, pull on this collar and it disconnects. So when it does connect, it provides compressed air. You can take pallets on and off. And when you're done, just pull it out. I like this because it goes through the door. Now, if we had some type of fancy solenoid system where the G-code would turn it on and off, that's fine. But at some point, there's gonna be a manual override outside of the machine. You do not want to run these with air pressure applied to it. So if this is plugged in and the operator forgets, they will not be able to close the door and press cycle start. That's why it's a backup safety thing. Off means locked, press cycle start, and you're ready to go. Let me give you a close-up shot of this. So as you can see, we run the airline out the side of the Pro Pallet base into this adapter that we made, which takes the push to connect fitting and on one side and has the quick disconnect male fitting on the other. It protrudes not even an inch, which is never a clearance issue. Now, as I mentioned earlier, you have your female fitting with the collar. Simple one-handed operation. That just provided compressed air to the base, and to disconnect it, all done.
Okay, so we've disconnected the airline, the pallet system is locked, the doors are closed, the program is loaded, and this is a moment where we hit cycle start. And all the planning, all the dreaming, all the engineering and design and programming comes to this point where when we hit cycle start, we see the payoff of five-axis machining. Here we go. Okay, so quick disclaimer here. Machining with coolant and filming it really stinks. So we figure we'll opt to show you some follow-up coolant-free footage, so bear with us. So tool one, 2.5-inch Kenna metal face mill. Pretty straightforward, just faces the top of all four parts. It does a rough pass and then a finish pass, removing 2/1000ths of material. Next tool up is a 3/8 three flute end mill. What it's doing here is it's just doing a pre-machine of the upper portion of the part, taking out as much material as possible. You'll see why, because we have this fork area in here and we just go through a really quick adaptive just to clear that out. Sure, we could slot it, but we have so much efficiency going on here with holding four parts at a time, multiple faces. I like to take lighter cuts and higher process reliability whenever I can. Okay, next tool, 2-inch long, three flute, zirconium coated end mill. We are going full depth. We're taking a 10% radial step over, and of course that full 2-inch length. It's actually, I think it's about 1.95 inch length of cut here. And we're just going around the whole part. Okay, now the next tool, exact same dimensions, 1/2 inch diameter with a 2-inch length of cut. We left 3/1000ths of material around the perimeter of the part, and we have this held in a hydraulic tool holder from YG1. Really great brand, affordably priced. I've been really happy with these hydraulic tool holders. Almost zero run out, especially when you're running longer tools like this. Run out is so important. One of my favorite drills, this is a two flute coolant through drill. Maybe I'll show you the original footage of when we drilled this. Through coolant drills are amazing. You plunge so fast. I think this was plunging at 120 inches a minute, which is actually quite conservative for a drill of this size. It's a letter R, 339.339 inches, plunging in and out. We could probably do, honestly, about double that. But again, process reliability is most important to us. The nice thing about this is the first time you're gonna see this drilling on the sides, it's on the front side, but then it goes back and it's drilling the air inlet hole on the right side of the part or furthest from us. Now this would only be made possible with a RotoVise and a fourth, or in this case, five-axis solution. Next tool up is a simple drill. This is just a little drill that's going in and breaking through into the main valve section. And of course, doing the exact same thing on the other single hole on the back side of it. Next tool, this is an 1/8 inch 27 NPT pipe tap. I'm gonna show you the real footage here because we obviously didn't run it dry. So it's gonna get a little messy here, but tin coating on this works beautifully in aluminum. Next tool, another big one. This is a 14.5 millimeter drill, through coolant as well, single straight plunge, again, for its size, about 150 inches a minute, very conservative on the feed rates, but of course that through spindle coolant works beautifully, blasts in, blasts out those chips, does an amazing job. We're actually running a reaming cycle, feeding in and out. That gives us a really nice wall finish whenever you run that reaming cycle with these through coolant carbide drills. Next tool, coming back with a 3/8 finish end mill. What we're doing, we're opening up this hole right here and we are going to finish it with a thread mill. Now, the thread mill requires pretty close tolerance. You don't want to take away too little or too much material and risk breaking it. Next tool, 1/4 inch chamfer. We are chamfering holes. We're chamfering any surface that needs a chamfer or an edge break. We don't do any deburring outside of the machine. That would be over processing or it would be wasted motion. A couple of lean principles there. We want to do as much work to the part as possible so that when these come out of the machine, they are off to the next operation or off to the anodizers. Bottom line, they're finished in the machine with little human interaction. Same concept here to chamfer the top side after all the previous top side work has been done. And one of the last tools is a 1/4 inch diameter, 20 pitch thread mill. If you're scared of thread milling, don't. These are such simple tools to program with any modern cam system. We use Fusion 360. And as you can see, it just makes easy work. We actually take the cut in two passes. One is obviously a rough. We leave 2/1000ths of material and come back with the finish pass. Leaves a really beautiful thread. Okay, last tool here. We're gonna see the advantage of making this part on a 5-axis machine. So far, we could have run everything on a 4th-axis, but here we're taking advantage of having an extra face available to the cutter. What we're doing here is we're just putting a shallow pocket in the face of the valve so that when we come back, we can place our sticker with our logo on it perfectly. It's a nice little detail that just looks really good. We used to originally put our stickers on the face of it, but adhesives and chips over time, they started collecting around the edges. We don't have that problem. As you can see, we use the same type of sticker on the face of our Pro Pallet System down at the bottom. It's in a pocket, does two things, of course. It makes it look good, plus it gives our assembly personnel the exact placement of where to put it. No crooked stickers. It just leaves just a much higher quality of part. And details, 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 we're coming in. And that pocket is only about 30 thousandths deep, but we're still gonna go in and chamfer that edge of the pocket, taking away any burrs, any sharp edges, making this look like a beautiful premium product that it is. And there you have it. So if you want to learn more about our products, including the RotoVise and Pro Pallet System behind me, look for the links below in the description. Now, if you want to become a better machinist, check out our Fixture Friday playlist. If you're into robotics and automation, we have a robotics series going on that's just about to wrap up as well. And of course, consider subscribing if we've earned it. So until next time, go innovate your production.